KFC 2010. Now, to remove the stereo, we need to remove the whole panel from around the stereo, which includes the heater controls and the display and the vents. Now, to remove this, it will be much easier to sit on the passenger side as you can get a better grip. All we need to do is prise the panel forward. So there's 2 to 3 clips on the bottom, 2 to 3 on the side, and 3 to 4 on the top, but it is extremely tight. Lucky enough, the dash is very, very soft and very, very, very forgiving, but still try and be as careful as possible. If we use the angle tool, like this one, it gives us a little bit more extra leverage. So if we start from a corner, gently pop the panel forward, and if you lift it with your fingers, you'll pop the bottom part of it out. On the top, we need to put the trim panel in, and then put it towards yourself to actually pull the panel forwards, because the whole thing has to come forwards. It doesn't go at an angle. So again, behind and pull forwards towards yourself. We can remove the panel that way. Once pulled forwards, you should be able to gain access to all of the wiring for the heater controls. Access to the wiring for the display. We can now pull it all the way forwards and gain access to the last two connections on the bottom of the heater controls. And finally, on the very bottom there is an aircon tube which will gently pull off. And that's the main control panel itself out of the way. Now there are just 4 Phillips screws to remove the stereo itself from the housing. Gently give the stereo a wiggle, and we'll be able to pull it forwards, lifting up all of the cabling. Now we can access the aerial connection there, which is a FARC run, so we push the pin down and pull the stereo out. We then push a pin on either side of the top quad lock, the top 20 pin connector, and we just have our basic ISO power and speakers. Now on the bottom, I have one last little clip to remove the stereo.